Okay, I got two nice holes, or two nice markers for holes. I'm going to go to the drill press, and then I'll be right back. Well, my template was off just a little bit. One hole fits fine. I'm going to have to file out the other hole. I've got a good fit for this one right back down here. That one, though, I've got to come and file just a little bit back over in that corner right there. So I'm going to get a little file. File that hole out. Won't take but just a moment. Many years ago, I was in the automotive parts business. In fact, my wife and I had a company over in Louisiana that we had built from the ground up. And that meant we built the building. We did everything. Stocked it, sold the parts, cleaned up, stocked, did everything. And actually, it turned out to be fairly successful. We sold it about 20 years ago. It's still in business today, still going strong. And we sold car parts. In there was an assortment of distributor screws. Remember, this was back in the 70s when cars had real distributors with points, condensers. Some of you guys know. Perhaps some of you are, well, I'm sure some people are watching that's never had the experience of changing points and condensers about every 12,000 miles in a car. Not bad to do that, just kind of aggravating. When you did, if you weren't careful, you'd lose one of the little screws like that. Now, just little small 630 screws, about a quarter of an inch long. Anyway, back to my story. When I sold the store, I realized that at the house, or somewhere or another, I had one of these little distributor screw assortments. And I thought, my goodness, I'll never use that thing. But the reality is, they make pretty good little project box screws for doing something just like this. So I just tap 632 into the project box holder, and then bingo, it holds the PC board in there. So I don't know if there's a moral other than the fact is, don't throw stuff away. You never know when you're going to see it or going to be able to use it again. So, you know, I think I'm still going to need to file that out some more. I don't know if that's going to fit over there or not. And I need to file that one out just a little bit more to make it fit down over here. It's not going to hurt anything. I'll come back here and finish it up tomorrow. And hopefully I'll get the second part up before too long. Now I've got to go in and take a hacksaw. And I'm going to just split the top surface of this PC board. And this is going to be a positive bus. And this will be the negative bus. And then I'll take this copper wire and then I'll solder each end to it. In reality, it's just going to go straight down. And what I'll do is I'll just come down and tap somewhere on that PC board the voltage of this thing. All right. Kind of a long time to build a very simple project, but that's part of the fun of it. I'm going to take this to the drill press, make that hole just a little bit bigger, and then we'll be back. Okay, well, I've got the PC board. You may have noticed some differences that I've had to. This is the slot down the middle. I don't know if you can see that just right. I'm trying to get it on the camera. But anyway, there's the slot that I cut with the hacksaw. And it's just to separate the two sides. I just eyeballed it. Didn't do a very good job eyeballing it because one side's a lot bigger than the other one. But it doesn't matter. This is just going to be inside it. I just need to separate the two circuits or these two buses that it goes by. You also found out that I had to go in and put a hole right here. And the reason that hole is there is because when I put it together a while ago, I don't know if you can see, I'll put it right here. You see that protrudes a little bit down there? Well, I had to actually go in and file. I actually drilled a little hole and then got a little triangular file to, I'll put that on backwards, but anyway, that's going to stick through there like that. So that's what that hole there is for. And again, it doesn't hurt anything because this is the side the circuit's going to go on. This side over here is, you could use a single side PC. This is not even going to be in the circuit at all. Not whatsoever. Well, you know what? It might be. I need to take and make sure that I do have that bolt hole. And I'm kind of glad I'm thinking this outside as I go on here. I need to make sure that these two bolt holes here on the bottom side are not touching anything, because that would bring that all the way across perhaps. Okay, so I'll do that with a little sanding paper. Take that right on down. Now the next thing to do is go in and measure for these power pole connectors. In essence, what will happen is these power pole connectors are going to be connected to this bus here with a piece of copper wire, solid copper wire. I think that's probably 12 gauge copper wire. It's a little piece I had here. So what will happen is, if you've seen the power pole or seen any other power pole stuff, that's the way the power pole will go, and that'll be down here like this. Of course, it's not going to be quite that tall or anything. I'll have to manage and manipulate some of that. But and then, in essence, this will go up in there, and that's going to be sticking through the side of it. So now I'm just going to put the tape back on here and measure for the power poles, go to the milling machine, and then mill out a place for the power poles to stick through. All right, so it's time to measure and do the box here. So I'm at, let me get my square where it'll measure correctly. So I've got a 2-inch box, so I'm just going to come over here and mark up here at 2 inches. And again, if I had masking tape, this would be a lot easier to deal with, but I don't. So that's the center line going that way. And then also I'll come across and put a center line here. And then I can come in like this. And now I can put my center line on the, all the way down. And again, I have no plans on this. This is typical. Make it up as you go. Now I want to see how far down I want my power pole to be, and let's see. I've got to take in consideration that I'm going to have this part right here up pretty close to the front of that. So that means a big portion of that's going to need to be sticking outside. So I can deal with that a little bit, but what I want to do is to get how far down I want it to be from the top of the power pole. So I'm just going to put that right here. I'm just coming down just to kind of look and see what's visually pleasing. That looks like a good place for the top. Do the same thing on this side. And here, I'm just going to have to use a straight edge of some kind to go across. All right, so I'm at 70. I'm at 70 thousandths, 0.70. Now I'm going to measure the width of this, which is 340. So now I need to know plus 0.340. I got a key that's stuck on that thing. Let me get another calculator. I'll go back to one that's almost 15 years old. I know y'all get thinking, do I have anything that's new in this place? Well, occasionally I do, but not much. This, again, this goes back several years with me. All right, 0.70 plus, what do I have? 330, 0.330. That's because I had this first measure wrong. What was that? Yeah, it was. 170. I'll get it right in a minute. Okay, 340 plus 0.340 equals 051. Let's be right there. Now I'm going to put that in there. It's exactly right. Get that off the side. So this one's easy. All I have to do here is just put it right in the middle and come down the side. Yeah, when you're doing this, use masking tape. Be glad you did.
Okay, okay, so this one's going to do exactly what I did yesterday, and that is just go down and drill that out or mill that out, and I'm using exactly the same, I'll drop my brush, I'm using exactly the same mill that I did yesterday, which is a 1/8 mill, which that means that's a 16th of an inch radius, and which in essence works out to be almost a square corner. So here, let's get started. You never know when you're going to run across something that you might use someday. Many years ago, well, that's not going to work. Let me tell my story in just a minute. Time to go back to the Dollar Tree and get a calculator. Throw that one away. Key sticks. So, and that one looks like the display is going out on me. Okay, that one goes to the trash.